When you mentioned me on Twitter, I was like, I'm not sure if I am good enough in Raycast to like show how I use it, but at the same time, I thought I'm sure like there's other people like me that they don't feel like they are users, but they really enjoy the app because that's just like amazing. So I was like, well, I'll let them judge if I am good enough or not.
You know, I actually want to take a step back a little bit and get to know, Raycast aside, what do you do when you're on your computer?
Usually when I'm on a computer, I'm like either working on my full-time job or on some personal like projects and stuff. So I feel like I'm all the time working. I don't really use my computer for like hobbies and things that are like outside this like work environment. Yeah, I feel like I'm primarily switching between like Figma, Visual Studio, browser, Slack, Screen Studio to share flows and stuff. So yeah, I feel like primarily I use tools for my work.
Cool. Well, then that sounds all good to me. I think that why don't we go ahead and maybe you can share your screen with us. There should be a little button here in Riverside.
Yeah, probably I can share the entire screen and how people usually do, like, because I just want to share my like best.
Yeah, we usually share the whole screen because Raycast is always just a part of your whole usage. Are you using the Raycast wallpaper?
Yeah, and that was not like just for this meeting. I really use it, and I use it on my phone actually as well.
Oh yeah, hang on.
Wait.
I use the black and white one. What I'm curious to know is how are you using Raycast? And we can keep this quite high level for now, just like the main things that you use Raycast for.
Primarily, I use Raycast for some work tasks. The Figma extension is something that I use a lot when I'm trying to find like a new project or a project that I'm working on really quick. Especially in Vercel, when I have like really a lot of files, it's really, really hard to navigate. So that's one extension that I use like dozens of times a day. Floating notes as well is another extension that I love. I type my notes here and like while I'm working, some things I need to remind, some things I want to like deep dive later. So it works kind of, you know, a quick backlog for my brain. And then like every now and then throughout the day, I just like share with my notes and then I reorganize in separate files.
I think that the way you're using floating notes is the way it was designed to be used. And I'm really happy to hear that because it's literally a brain dump, right?
Yeah, and I think the way the feature is designed, it really drives you to use that way. The fact that it's really raw and it's really straightforward really helps users understanding that it's just supposed to be like a brain dump.
So what else?
Screen Studio is another extension that I use a lot. Often I find myself wanting to explain something in details or to record something to post on Twitter. Window management, I think I use like hundreds and billions of times a day. I use it all the time. And like for me, it's one of the best features of Raycast. And it's super simple, but really, especially if you're a Mac user, it makes a lot of difference. Basically, I have some hotkeys assigned using like option and the arrows of the keyboard. Nothing super. There's a center to like half left, half right, maximize. So just like really, I toggle between all these options like all the time. Emojis, I use a lot as well. I think it's much faster than the Mac one. I also have a hotkey for that. I use option E for emojis. So for me, it feels really much faster than the native emoji picker.
Is there a reason why you're using the extension instead of the one that comes out of the box? Do you prefer the layout or anything like this?
Honestly, I don't have a smart justification. I think I just found this one first for some reason. I really like that the list layout, so I just got used to it. So, yeah.
Up until now, everything that you've shown us has been through hotkeys, right? You haven't actually opened Raycast yet. Do you want to just tell us a little bit how you think about hotkeys? Like, do you have a system in your head that helps you memorize them?
I do, and it's actually pretty straightforward. I assign always option. Option is like my default like hotkey initiator, if I can put it like that. And then the second key is usually related to the name of the extension or the nature of what I'm doing. My Figma hotkey, for instance, is option D of like designs. My AI hotkey is option A of AI. I just think that this system got stuck in my head, and for me, it's easier, you know, to not really think about like multiple combinations of keys. So yeah, I use hotkeys quite a lot. Not for everything though, for time zone conversions and currency conversions, I don't use hotkeys. So I like really open Raycast and I type. Since the beginning, I tried to set this mindset of like, I just try to make things simple. I don't need to be a power user. I just want to like improve my workflow, even if it's like 10, 20%. It's already worth it. And yeah, for me, it works perfectly. So
you mentioned that you're in France right now.
Yeah.
You're from Brazil, like myself. Are you doing time zone mainly because you want to find out what time it is in Brazil? Or is it mainly for work because you have colleagues around the world?
It's mainly for work. So basically 1 p.m. CST, 2 BRT. Because in Vercel, we are like fully distributed across the globe and you're fully remote. I always find myself like converting time zones. And for me, the easiest way is just use Raycast. The same for currency. If I want to convert like, I don't know, 100 US dollars to euros, that's much, much, much faster to do it here than any other thing that I've tried.
And
translator as well. I'm sorry to cut you because it reminds me of like translation, which is another extension that I use a lot. My partner is French and in Vercel, we obviously speak English. My native language is Portuguese. So like every now and then I'm thinking like, oh, how that works, like is in English or is in French.
And how did you launch the translator? Did you use option T?
Yeah.
Nice.
Exactly.
I like your system. Let's move on to spicy questions because I think you're going to enjoy them. So is there anything you don't like about Raycast? I'm specifically curious about your answer because you're the first external guest that we have.
I think one thing that I don't like about Raycast is how intimidating it can feel in the beginning, especially if you're not like an engineer or designer or someone inside this tech bubble. I do feel like it can be intimidating and you can feel like, oh, I just don't need it or it's just too complicated for me, when in fact it's not true.
Do you think there's anything about the design that kind of makes it intimidating, or you think this is more like a conceptual thing?
I think it's more of a conceptual thing. Like design wise, it's really close to Spotlight, so it brings this familiarity of like Spotlight features, which kind of makes sense. I think it's more conceptually the fact that it's a launcher and you have like several extensions and you have like several ways to configure it. I imagine that this is an entry barrier for some people because that was my path. Like I heard about Raycast, I thought about, wow, that might be too complicated for me. Maybe I don't need it. Then with the management, and I said, oh, I definitely need it because I want it. And then I started using it a little bit like, I think I'll just be like a basic user and I won't take the most out of it. Then suddenly I was like realizing that, oh, that's simple. It's easy to configure. It's easy to like wrap my head around it. But it was definitely a process.
Is there an app that Raycast completely replaced for you? So maybe something that you were using before and then after installing Raycast, you just didn't need it anymore?
GPT, for sure. Now I only use Raycast AI. I don't open ChatGPT in OpenAI anymore.
I feel like when we launched Raycast AI, being able to just get access pretty much at the OS level, that was the biggest game changer because then you're not losing focus, right? You're not switching context. Is there anything you could show us on your screen on how you use Raycast AI? Do you have like a demo for us?
Yeah, sure. Okay, I need like a small copy for a hero of a landing page that I'm designing. So I'll just like toggle Raycast AI option A, create a short description for a hero section of a cloud provider, whatever. In this case, it feels that's just too much. I don't need all of that. So I'll just like revert back to my last prompt with the arrow key. And I just added. So create a description for a hero section of a cloud provider in two sentences. Basically, I'll just like iterate on top of that. And yeah, that feels good. That feels perfect. So I'll just like come here, copy, tasting Figma, and I'll do that like several times.
What's the extension that you use the most?
Window management.
Nice. Now, let me just explain something here for people who don't know. Almost everything in Raycast is considered an extension, but there are some extensions that are native. Native, we mean we built them. They come with Raycast out of the box, and window management is one of them. What's the extension you use the most that is not built in?
Currently I think the Figma extension to find files.
What is your all-time top extension for designers?
color picker.
What about an extension that you have, you've installed it, but you never use it?
Spotify.
What?
So, I tried, but I don't know. There's nothing personal, though.
No, it's fine.
It's great, but yeah, I don't use it a lot.
Good. So yeah, that kind of wraps up our What's In My Raycast with Mariana. I really, really enjoyed seeing how you use Raycast. And I must say that you definitely underplayed yourself. I was expecting that you were not going to be, you know, a power user. You were saying how, you know, you don't think you use it a lot, but I'm really impressed. You use it quite a lot.
I told you I was intimidated, but I'm happy. I'm happy I could show off my Raycast a little bit.
Do you want to just let people know what you do and your socials if you want people to follow you on X, shall we say?
I'm currently working at Vercel. We are building V0, which is something that I'm really excited about. I invite you all to try if you feel like. My handle is like kind of hard to pronounce. So maybe we can write somewhere here. I don't know. If you like have any feedback about how I use Raycast or about V0, Vercel, my work in general, super happy to hear and connect. So yeah.